We never heard a dial tone or anything.
Okay.
What happened?
We have no idea what happened.
Oh, my goodness. I've just been desperately waiting to talk to you guys.
We know you have.
Mike O'Malley, thank you so much for waiting for our phones to correct
our
themselves.
Our fellow New Englander.
Yes, our fellow New Englander. Of course, we're in Portland, Maine. Mike is in the new movie Sully. In the new movie Sully, about Chesley Sullenberger. And Mike, we talk to a movie reviewer every week, and they said that you are spectacular in this movie.
Oh, thank you so much, because I just read a review where the reviewer described me as having a doorstop of a face. That's good to hear. I was like, I turned to my wife immediately and I said, listen, I apologize. I don't know how you ended up marrying somebody who had a doorstop of a face. So I'm sorry you've had to, I'm sorry you vowed to marry a guy and that's what you have to look for. But if you need to, move some furniture today and you need the door propped open, my face gets in front of there for you. It's great to talk to you up in Portland, Maine. My cousin Marion O'Malley lives in Portland, Maine. My cousin Timothy O'Malley, and we've got great, great friends up there. If Paula Blake is listening in her classroom, hello to Paula Blake. She's one of my dear friends from college.
Shouldn't she be teaching something right now?
Well, you know what? Here's the thing. If you've had to be in a room full of 6-year-olds for longer than 15 minutes, you know you want to just make them busy with busy work and get listening to the radio.
Yeah. The teacher has to take a little wine break now, kids.
Right. Wouldn't that be nice? Hey, kids, look, do your multiplication tables. I'm just going to have a cocktail over here.
Mike,
look at us. Look at us laughing as teachers are working hard to educate America and keep us, I believe, what are we now, 17th in intellectual...
Oh, my God, we moved up. We moved up.
Yeah, you always see those things like, 17. Where's America in math? Yeah. We're like 26th in math. Which seems to be working out.
Who do you play in the movie?
I play... So, for those of you who don't know, Captain Sullenberger is played by Tom Hanks. This movie's directed by Clint Eastwood. And it's about the gentleman who landed a plane on the Hudson River in, I think it was 2015, and everyone lived. And I play a National Transportation Safety Board. I play the lead investigator. So I'm trying to figure out what caused the crash. Because even though we're very happy that everyone lived, we still have to do our job and find out, was it pilot error? Was it a mechanical failure? What happens so that we can fix it and prevent it from happening in the future?
You know, I just read, you probably read this too, Mike, where some of the guys in the NTSB and some of the investigators are kind of worried about the film because they're worried that they may be portrayed as the bad guys trying...
Oh, you know, I mean, listen, this is... I don't even play a real person. I play a composite of a person. The movie's called Sully. It's not called the National Transportation Safety Board Investigators. These guys are great, great guys who do their work and ask questions. And if people can't make the leap to understand that as a dramatic device, one of the people playing a lead investigator seems to be a little grumpy, then, you know, I feel bad for them. Because the truth of the matter is that we all know that there's good cops and bad cops. We know that there's good detectives and bad detectives. We know that there's people who are good at their job and very friendly and lovely and accommodating. And there's other people who are short, blunt, and quick with their words. And if people can't make that distinction, then they really shouldn't go out to the movies because they're not going to have any conflict in movies and they're not going to see any good ones.
All right, here, let me paraphrase for you, Mike, for those listening. STFU.
No, I understand. Listen, I'm not saying that I don't, if you work at a job and you feel that, hey, I'm a really good guy. It would be like saying, you know, you saw a movie about a selfish, self-serving actor, and I would be like, how dare they portray actors as self-serving and self-centered? It's just so unthoughtful. I'm a really good guy. It's like, yeah, there's really good guys, and there's really selfish, self-serving actors. And this is a film about how a man dealt with his fame afterwards. Look, I don't think, now maybe it's just on me, and I just don't portray any nuance well, but in my portrayal of this movie. But when you're asking questions, Clint Eastwood really succeeds by putting you in the shoes of Tom Hanks and Captain Sullenberger by making you feel like after you've landed a plane and saved all these people, why would anyone have any questions about how it was done? Whereas the way I approach my role was, look, I'm just asking simple questions. My question is, did you have anything to drink? Are you having any trouble at home? I mean, what if the answer was, yes, as a matter of fact, I had 3 mimosas before I took off today? Well, then we'd be like, well, now we know why you crashed the plane in the river. You were drunk. I mean, we only know the answer after the question's been asked.
I totally understand. Yep. I can't.
You know, so, I mean, this is just usual movie nonsense, right? You make a movie about a famous person, and somebody's like, I don't really like how I was portrayed. You know what I mean? It's not, you know, I'm going to do a movie about the heroic, investigator that nobody knows, you know, who's, you know, what he's done. But I get it. It's not dramatic unless you have somebody who's a little bit grumpy in my part. And if people can't get around that, they shouldn't go to the movie.
You mentioned Clint Eastwood, the director, and you're working with Tom Hanks as well. Did the Mike O'Malley from the early 90s, who was the host of great shows like Guts on Nickelodeon and Get the Picture, ever imagine he'd be working with Clint Eastwood and Tom Hanks later?
It's a real thrill to work with them. And just like anybody, you know, when you arrive on a set, and I'm going to be 50 this year, so, you know, it feels like a great accomplishment to be associated with two iconic actors and filmmakers like Tom Hanks and Clint Eastwood. I would be lying, and I'm not lying, to say that when I was in college and I saw Tom Hanks' career unfolding, and then I would go see movies that Clint Eastwood was in, sure. That's why I decided, as a guy who grew up in Nashua, New Hampshire, and went to the University of New Hampshire, and I said to myself, I could be doing that. Yeah. So, yes, I imagine myself being in a movie with both of those guys. It took far longer than I expected.
I did, but by the way, I did love you on Get the Picture and Guts.
Thank you. I had a lot of fun doing both of those shows. And you know what? Sometimes people bring up my Nickelodeon past almost like in a way that, you know, it feels like they're heckling me. But I was very proud to work on those shows and you know, portray what I thought was like a big brother to a lot of those kids. I loved working on Nickelodeon. I took those jobs very, very seriously. And I think part of the reason is because I took it seriously, a lot of the people at Nickelodeon helped me pursue my other career as a writer. And you know, Nickelodeon would buy out the theater of a play that I was writing back in the 90s. And so, you know, I'm very, very fond of my time at Nickelodeon.
And I loved you in Yes, Dear.
Thank you. I wish they were still making it.
I wish they were, too. I loved Anthony Clark, and I loved you in that.
So funny. I mean, Yes, Dear was great. And, you know, I've had a very, you know, varied and fun career, and then I got to do Glee for a long time.
Yeah.
One of the things I'm really excited about right now is that I co-wrote the book to a musical with actually Greg Garcia from, you know, Yes Dear, who created Yes Dear. We wrote the book to a Jimmy Buffett Broadway musical that's opening in La Jolla, California.
That's cool.
And hopefully going to Broadway in 2018. So working with Jimmy Buffett, it's just been tremendous.
That's awesome.
And the thing I'm most proud about right now, other than Sully, is I created a show that's on Starz. Not everybody has this network. It's a pay cable network. It's a movie channel. But they're starting to do original programming. And I created a show called Survivor's Remorse with LeBron James and Tom Werner, who owns the Boston Red Sox, of course, or co-owns the Boston Red Sox. And we're going into our fourth season, and I'm just a writer on that show. It's about a black family from Dorchester, Massachusetts. They move to Atlanta, Georgia, and become, you know, famous basketball player. And how do you really begin to navigate the world of fame and fortune when you haven't had it your whole life?
Right.
So
Mike, you might make me get Starz.
Please, you got to get it. Or you know what? Just get the app and just try it out.
Okay.
You
know, I've heard of that show. That sounds.
Yeah.
I had no idea you were involved. That's really cool. Yeah, I heard you mention Red Sox, so I got to ask. What do you think our chances are?
I think we're going to go quite far if we can't, you know, go all the way. I mean, the pitching looked pretty you know, great this last weekend. It's just we couldn't score some runs in San Diego, and that was unfortunate. We did, you know, finally in the last game, but I like this team. I like the young guys on this team, and look, we're so fortunate, you know, having. I grew up in New Hampshire and in Boston in the 70s, 80s, and 90s, and to have this run with the Boston Red Sox and the New England Patriots have been great for both teams. Have been great for over a decade. It's just, I just enjoy every minute. I'm just glad that they're great.
You know, I'm not going to move on. I'm sorry, I got a live one.
We're talking to Michael
Malley.
Okay,
goodbye, guys. Thanks.
Hey,
see ya.
Bye, Mike.
And we're done. He liked to talk.